Rainey, and today we are making chocolate chip cookies. Now, I'm not saying that I make the best chocolate chip cookie. There are a lot of schools of thought on chocolate chip cookies. Fluffy, crunchy, chewy, whatever. I am saying, though, that a lot of people have told me these are the best chocolate chip cookies, so I'm gonna share the recipe with you and make the tweaks that you want to make it how you like it. So first we'll go over the ingredients and then we'll get started. You need flour, of course, baking soda, brown sugar, salt, 2 sticks of butter, eggs, and then we're gonna have Ghirardelli chocolate chips. So to me, these are the best ones, but if you are a Nestle person, you do you. But these are my favorite. And you only need one of the small bags or half of these, this big bag. And vanilla. Okay, we've preheated our oven to 350, and while it's coming to temp, we put our butter in to melt. And in the meantime, we're gonna go ahead and mix our dry ingredients. So we need flour, baking soda, and salt. And we're gonna do 3 cups of all-purpose flour. The flour, you scoop it in and level it off, filling the cup. 3 cups is a lot of flour for a cookie recipe, but I think it gives it a good consistency, so it's a little bit different. And with cooking, you can be a little more free, but with baking, you kind of got to follow the science. So if you aren't sure about the flour, you can always start with 2 1/2 or 2 3/4 cups of flour and then go from there. So we've got 3 cups of all-purpose flour. I'm going to do a teaspoon. Now we'll add a teaspoon of salt. And I just use like the same sea salt that I have, but it is finely ground. If you use bigger chunks of sea salt, you may want to do a little bit more, but I probably wouldn't. A teaspoon seems to be enough. And then I'll do a teaspoon of baking soda. And I just, for baking soda, I don't measure exactly like whether it's level or not. I just go for it. So those are our wet ingredients. Those are our dry ingredients. I'm going to just give them a stir. I don't typically sift my flour. I should. I just don't have a sifter. And so I just stir it all around and kind of incorporate some air into it. Okay. Now we'll check on our butter and see if it's melted. Since our butter is melted, I'm going to pour it into the brown sugar. While the oven is preheating, I'm gonna put 2 packed cups of brown sugar in my mixing bowl. Packed just means once you scoop the sugar in, you actually pack it down, and then you fill it up more if you need to. So that's 1 cup. And I'm gonna start the mixer. A lot of cookie recipes call for some brown sugar and some white sugar. This is just brown sugar, and I think you'll like it. Things one at a time, slowly mixing in between. And this is important to not overmix the butter and the sugar and the eggs, because then the cookies get too runny. So mix it in just until it's well combined. Once you've added 2 eggs and mixed it, you're gonna add in 1 teaspoon of vanilla, and go ahead and turn the mixer on just to incorporate that as well. Up next, we have our dry ingredients. Typically, when making cookies or really any kind of baked thing, you might do the dry ingredients and the wet ingredients separately, and that's true for this too. So I've already mixed up the flour, the baking soda, and the salt, and I'm gonna add them into the mixture. And again, being careful just to incorporate them, not to overmix them. Okay, before I do anything else, I'm gonna add the chocolate chips. And then if I decide the dough needs a little more flour, like if it's too gooey and not sticking together well enough, we'll add a little bit more. You just kind of have to play with it a little bit. Take your baking sheet. We're going to cover it with parchment paper so that the cookies don't stick. What I also like about this this is if you have a bunch of cookies to make and maybe you only have one or two baking sheets, you can just slide the parchment paper off and then do the next batch on the same cookie sheet, so you don't have to wait for them to cool before you use the spatula to get them off. What I like to use for cookies is ice cream scoop. So this is a small one, it's gonna be about one tablespoon, and it makes cookies that are about 80 calories each. Not that important when we're talking about cookies, but if you want to make a bunch for a group of people, I'd probably use this one. But if you want to make a fun, rich, like special treat kind of cookie, like maybe just for your family or friends are coming over, or you want to put ice cream on top of it, you want to use this guy. This is a bigger scoop, and it is going to be about a fourth of a cup. So it's about four of these. So it comes to be quite the cookie. Let's check it out. We've got our mixture here. You can also spray the inside of your ice cream scoop with nonstick spray if you want to kind of help the cookies come off a little easier. I usually don't have a huge issue. If they are sticking too much to the ice cream scoop, your cookie may need a little bit more flour. But I just take an even scoop, kind of like that, and just pop it on the paper. I don't smush it down, nothing. I like it just like that. And then you just keep doing it. And when I scoop it, I just smash it against the side so that it's flat, because you want them to all be about the same size. And the main reason is cookies are all gonna bake in the oven at different temperature at different times if they're different sizes. So if they're all about the same size, then you get good even baked cookies. Because they are so big, I usually only do about six to a tray. And that's another reason why this is great if you're just doing this for, you know, a special night or a small crowd. But I would not do this big for a bunch of people because it takes a lot of work. But they're ready to go. I'm going to put them in the oven. You've got to watch it. It ends up being about 11 to 13 minutes depending on your oven. I like to err on the side of 11 to 12 minutes if they're going to sit all night. Like if I'm not taking them until like tomorrow or something. But if you are serving them tonight, you probably want to go to like more of the 13, maybe even 14 minute route. You just kind of have to watch it based off of your oven. So let's put them in and see what happens. Okay, while those are baking, I'm actually going to show you another trick. So I'm actually making these for just the video. So we don't need a bunch of huge cookies sitting around today. So I do like to go ahead and wrap some, take your cookie dough, and wrap it in parchment paper and store it in the freezer so that you have cookies on hand anytime someone comes over, or if you need them for later on this week, you can put them in the fridge. Now, whenever you refrigerate or chill dough at all, it does change the cookie consistency just a little bit, but I think it only helps these cookies, so don't worry, they're still gonna be delicious. To put it in the freezer, I just take my sheet of parchment paper and empty all the extra dough onto it. If I were going to do this with the entire recipe, since it makes 12 big cookies, I would probably separate it into two parchment paper pieces just so you don't have so much dough in one. And now, you can just use your hands, but it gets a little messy, so instead I like to wrap the parchment paper around it. And kind of press it out into a cylinder shape, the same way you would refrigerated dough at the grocery store. You do want to make sure, though, once you get it into the cylinder shape, you've got to stretch out these wrinkles or they're going to be frozen into the dough, so you won't have uniform cookies. So, it's in that cylinder shape, and now I'm going to manipulate it with my hands to get it to be how I want it. So this is how you can, when you open it up from the freezer, you're going to slice them like this. So you want to roll it out for the size cookie that you want. Like if I keep it bunched up like this, they're gonna be really big, which is fine. But if you want them to be a little bit thinner, you just roll it out like that. Don't worry about the perfect shape. They're still gonna bake into delicious cookies. But to get them a little more rounded, we can just roll it back. And forth a couple times, and we have what looks just like your refrigerated cookie dough. Now, I'm gonna wrap it up and smooth out the wrinkles as I go. With the extra parchment paper on the edges, I do want it to be airtight, so I'm gonna fold it in a little bit and close it, just like that. Paper is great because then when you unroll it from the freezer or refrigerator, it won't stick to the parchment paper. So you should get, you should just be able to open it up and easily cut your cookies. But it's not great for being airtight. So I've rolled in the edges to help seal it a little bit. And you could tape them at that point too. But I want to also take it on this plastic wrap so that I can make sure it is airtight. So I'm going to roll it onto the plastic wrap as well. And then push in the edges to seal. And we're good. We have cookie dough for whenever anyone comes over for like the next, I don't know, year. Okay guys, they've been resting for about 5 minutes and there's one missing. I don't know what happened there. Not the point of the story. Now, when you pick them up, they should be firm enough to where it like stays. But if you're gonna package these, you probably wanna do, let them sit overnight, true with any cookie. And when you open it up, it is this like chewy, gooey texture. That's the kind of cookie I like. I get that not everybody likes that, but the longer they sit, the more firm they get too. And then if you want it to be a little less gooey, tell me in the comments how you like your cookies. And be sure to check out my new Patreon membership where you can join and you'll get weekly meal plans and more. It's gonna be great.
Now I'm packing these up to share with someone else. I hope you make these and enjoy.